Good morning, children. Today we are doing worksheet. Okay, worksheet 2 of theme 4. Theme 4, worksheet 2 was left. I have completed theme 5. So I have gone back to theme 4 now. Since from theme 5 we will be doing comprehension, that's why I had started that theme first. Okay, now I am returning back to theme 4. We will be doing grammar from here. Now, the things in grammar which you have here, we have already done. Okay. But I'll still recapitulate whatever has been done beforehand. We have done it in our grammar books. Okay. Now, here in this worksheet, we have got about tense. Okay. Now, you all know there are three kinds of tense: present tense, past tense, and future tense. Okay. Now, here see, in your workbook, it's given what is a tense. The tense of a verb tells us about the time of the action. It tells us whether the action has taken place in the past, is taking place in the present, or will take place in the future. So these are the three ways in which tense of a verb tells us when the action is being done. Okay. Now coming down here, see, it's given there. Present tense, past tense, and future tense. Number one, Shiva goes to school. This is present tense. Past tense, what will we write? Shiva went to school. Future tense, what will we write? Shiva will go to school. So these are three kinds of tenses which we are generally using. Now read the table below to understand how different verb forms are used for different tenses. So when we come down here, see simple present tense, simple past tense, and simple future tense. What is it? See, the girl sings a song, simple present tense. The girl sang a song is simple past tense. And simple future tense will be the girl will sing a song. Now, present continuous tense, what will we write? The girl is singing a song. It's present continuous, going on singing. Past continuous, the girl was singing a song. She had done it, suppose a day before. So, the girl was singing a song. Now, future continuous tense, what will we write? The girl will be singing. Suppose she'll be singing a song tomorrow. So, in future continuous tense, what will we write? The girl will be singing a song. Okay. Now, see, coming down for present perfect tense, which we have just done, what will we write? The girl has sung a song in present perfect tense. Past perfect tense, what will we write? The girl had sung a song. And in future, the girl will have sung a song. Okay. So, this is what is all about present, past and future tense. Now, when we come down here, we have got present perfect continuous tense also. In perfect continuous tense, when you write, what will you write? The girl has been singing a song. Okay, present perfect continuous. Past perfect continuous, the girl had been singing a song. And future perfect continuous, the girl will have been singing a song. Future perfect continuous, we are just doing. Okay, just doing now. So, it's very easy for you all to understand present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous and future perfect continuous. Okay. Now, when we come down here, see. Read carefully what Ravi did during a week-long break. Then write a diary entry as Ravi using simple past tense. See here, these are the lines given. You have to write down here what Ravi had done for that week. So, break started and break ended on Sunday. So these are all the works done by Ravi. I expect that all my children are going to fill up these blanks by yourself. Okay, that's why I've left this blank. This space blank. So that you all can do it yourself. Because I've taught you all everything. Present also, past also, future also. So you all will be doing these blanks yourself. Your school will be organizing a fete on coming Saturday. Write a notice using simple future tense. Now, this one we will be doing in our writing class. Okay. no need of doing it now. We will be writing it down in our writing class, that is on Saturday. Any Saturday we will be doing it. It's not that this Saturday only we'll be doing it, because this time we do not have notice writing. Okay. So we might not do it. Now coming down here, see number B3. Rewrite each sentence in the perfect continuous tense as indicated in the bracket. So where it is given present, we have to write present perfect continuous. Where it is given past, we have to write past perfect continuous. We have to write it in perfect continuous. Okay. Now see number one. I bought a bunch of orchids in present perfect continuous. What will it be? I have been bringing a bunch of orchids. Okay. I have been bringing a bunch of orchids. Now number two. My father was writing a letter in past tense. My father had been writing a letter in past perfect continuous tense. Okay. Now number three. The teacher will teach a new topic. In future perfect continuous tense, the teacher will have been teaching a new topic. Okay. Now number four. The girls will wear denims in future perfect continuous tense. What will we write? The girls will have been wearing denims. Will have been wearing denims. Okay. In future perfect continuous. Now number five. Mother was shopping for new clothes. Past perfect continuous. Mother had been shopping for new clothes. You all will write clothes there. Okay. Now number six. The cat drank all the milk. In present perfect continuous tense, the cat has been drinking all the milk. Okay? Now coming up here. Just see. Fill in the blanks with the correct tense of forms of the verbs given in brackets. There are verbs given in the brackets here. We will be completing it with the correct tense forms according to our sentence. Number one. They dashed to the railway station. In simple past, what will we write? They went to the railway station. Number two, the police dashed the crime scene very soon. The police will reach the crime scene very soon since it's simple future. Number three, all the stationery dash on the table. Simple present are on the table. All the stationery are on the table. Now number four. He dashed for the last 10 hours. He has been sleeping for the last 10 hours. Okay, present perfect continuous. Has been sleeping. Okay. Now number 5. I dashed these books from my school library. I have borrowed these books from my school library in present perfect. Now number 6. She was tired because she dashed for 2 hours. Past perfect continuous. So she had been standing. She was tired because she had been standing. Okay. Now number 7. When I reached the school, the bell dash already ring. In past perfect, the bell had already rung. Okay. Now number 8. The bus dash, just dash, leave is the verb given. In present perfect, the bus has just left. Okay. Number 9. I dash, not dash over the grass. Simple future. I will not trample over the grass. Okay. Now number 10. When our flight lands, our host dash for over 5 hours at the airport. Will have been waiting. Wait will be. Will have been waiting. Okay. Future perfect continuous. Okay, children. Now coming down here. Write down 6 aims of your life which you have set for yourself long back. You may or may not accomplish them, but use past perfect tense. You will use past perfect tense. And write down 6 aims of your life here. Okay, now worksheet 3. Worksheet 3 is very easy. with articles. What are articles? You all know A and an are indefinite articles, and da is the definite article. You all know this. So we are going to fill in the blanks with A and or da. Let's see here. Number one, Shivam likes to play the guitar, but Sita likes to play the flute. Number two, please give me the glass that is lying on the table. Number three, there is a neem tree and a banyan tree near my house. Number four, the great writer Salman Rushdie wrote an amazing thriller story. Number five, we saw the kangaroo and an alligator in the jungles of Australia. Now here if you write, we saw a kangaroo and an alligator in the jungles of Australia, even then it is correct. Okay. Number six, could you please water the plants? Okay. Now number C2, tick the correct articles. India has an ancient cultural heritage. Number two, the people of India celebrate all festivals together. Number three, the chief festival in Punjab is Lohri. Number four, the man you met yesterday was a teacher. Number five, the porridge was kept on the table. Now, if you write the porridge is kept on a table, even then it is correct. Okay. Number six, refer to a dictionary whenever you have a doubt. Okay. Number seven, I need to visit my granny during the holidays. Number eight, Amit has come across a lot of new words. So this is what is there. Now number C3, what is written? Read the conversation given below and fill in the articles wherever required. Put a cross if no article is required in a blank. Number 1, C, where is Rajini? No article is required. Number 2, ma'am, she missed the school bus. Number 3, teacher, we should be regular to school to excel in education. No article required. Number 4, Rani, yes ma'am, regularity should be maintained at all times. Cross there, okay? Next, Richa speaks up. Should we give her a call and ask her to come as soon as possible? Teacher, yes. Go to the office and inform her. Go to the office and inform her. Richa, yes ma'am, I'll go and make a call. Now read the email and correct the articles wherever required. I have done it for you all. Still, I expect you all to do it for me. Okay? So this much here for your workbook. Okay, I shall be sending you all a PDF also, okay, of all these. Still, children, please try to solve it up yourself. And if any problem you all face, please tell me. Okay. Thank you.